45 years have passed since she was banished. What could she have done to deserve so long and terrible a punishment?
What could she have done? What a foolish question. She married a mortal. I lately married a mortal.
Oh. Is it injudicious to marry a mortal?
Injudicious. It strikes at the very root of the whole fairy system. By our laws, any fairy who marries a mortal dies.
But I like you do not die.
Thank you, Captain Shaw.
My pleasure, ma'am.
Oh, nice.
You've been behaving yourself.
Guys.
Two of those.
A royal fairy peasant and counted for?
Yes, Your Majesty. We have Tidy and Lixa and our little Lou, Brandy and Spriteful and Boomerang, too, Ariel and Flirty and Maestra.
Ooh.
Well, what's wrong? She ensures that the orchestra all gets along. Brainy and Glitter and Celia, that's me. And if she hadn't died, there'd be Idolette.
Died? What is all this about Idolette dying? Of course she didn't die, because your queen, who loved her with some passing love, commuted her sentence to penal servitude for life on condition that she left her husband without a word of explanation and never communicated with him again.
And that sentence of penal servitude, she is now working out on her head at the bottom of a stream.
Yes, but when I banished her, I gave her all the pleasant places of the earth to dwell in. I'm sure I never intended that she should live at the bottom of the stream. It makes me perfectly wretched to think of the discomfort she must have undergone.
Well, then why not forgive her? 25 years is a long time, and think how we loved her.
Loved her? What was your love to mine? Why, she was invaluable to me.
Who taught me to curl myself in a buttercup?
Who?
Who taught me to swing upon a cobweb?
Who?
Lampy!
Oh.
Who taught me to gain courage from morning to drop?
Who?
I Lampy!
Oh, but it was me! Oh, then give her back to us, great queen, for your sake, not for ours.
Oh, I should be strong! I should be marble,
but I am living.
Her punishment has been heavier than I am.